What do you have to do to have faith? The answers to our prayers are already here.
Yes.
Isn't it that good?
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Good. And that isn't all. You know, we have two solos. That's a duet. We have other duets, I'm sure. But I want you to realize that God is always blessing us. And he doesn't wait for us to ask him for blessings. And we need to remember that this is God's church and it's God's work.
Yes.
And even though sometimes the devil may try to get in among us and cause problems, he's not going to succeed. He is not going to succeed. And God 90 is going to flourish. God is going to be served here. His name is going to be glorified. We will be brought to spiritual maturity. And we will be ready for the kingdom when Jesus comes. Let us have patience. There are more problems to come. Anyone who will serve God in this world will suffer persecution. So we need to be ready. But if we study the word and we pray, God has promised to keep us from evil. Keep us from the evil one. Protect us from the devil and his angels.
Yes.
And to bless us so that we can be saved in his kingdom.
Amen.
At this time, we'll ask the deacons and deaconesses to come forward for the day's scripture offerings. And of course, I'm concerned about something broader, wider, deeper, higher than just your tithes and offerings. Giving your tithes and offerings is a result of your having given something else.
Yes.
That is giving your heart to God.
Amen.
That is what concerns me.
Amen.
I want you to give yourself to God, and it's not going to matter about the tithes and offerings. They will be given, and they will be given in the right way from your heart, not like a Pharisee who gives it so that everybody can see.
Awesome.
But from your heart, you're going to be giving it because the Holy Spirit has put that spirit in you to give your entire life and all your possessions to the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. At this time, let's bow our heads. Our Heavenly Father, we are so thankful to you for the privilege you have given us of being workers in your cause. We thank you for your blessings. We thank you for all that you have done for us. And we come this morning to bring a small part of ourselves to thee. We ask that thou wouldst accept it, continue to bless us, and plant our feet on higher ground, we pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. It is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to sing praises unto his name, O Most High, to show forth thy loving kindness in the morning and thy faithfulness every night. Upon an instrument of 10 strings and upon the psaltery, upon the harp with a solemn sound. For thou, Lord, hast made me glad through thy will. I will triumph in the woods of thy hand. O Lord, how great are thy works, and thy thoughts are very deep. A brutish man knoweth not, neither does a fool understand this. When the wicked spring as the grass, and when all the workers of iniquity do flourish, it is that they shall be destroyed forever. But thou, Lord, art most high forevermore. For lo, thine enemies, O Lord, for lo, thine enemies shall perish. All the workers of iniquity shall be scattered. But my horn shall thou exalt like the horn of a unicorn. I shall be anointed with fresh oil, mine eyes also shall see my desire on mine enemies, and my ears shall hear my desire of the wicked that riseth against me. The righteous shall flourish like a palm tree. He shall grow like a cedar in Lebanon. Those that be planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. They shall still bring forth fruit in old age. They shall be fat and flourishing. To show that the Lord is upright is my rock, and there is no unrighteousness in him. Bring you all the tithes to the storehouse, that they may meet in mine house, and prove me now the evidence of the Lord of hosts, if I will not